with this in the background, Denise and I are getting ready for Yom Kippur in the year 2000. We had gone to Kol Nidre Service the evening before. We went to sleep early because she fasts, although I don't fast on Yom Kippur. And at 5:30 in the morning, the telephone rings. It's on her side of the bed. She answers it. She pushes me, wakes me up, and she says, "Eric, this is Stockholm calling. It must be for you. It's not for me." So I answer the phone, and it's the executive secretary of the Nobel Foundation, Hans Jörnvall, who informs me that I've just won the Nobel Prize, and I'm sharing it with Arvid, Carlsson, and Paul Greengard. Unbelievable. I couldn't believe my eyes. And then he told me what the protocol was and what was expected of me. And he spoke for about 5 or 10 minutes or something like that. But I didn't open my mouth during all of that period. Denise had never seen me silent for so long. She thought that something was wrong. Finally, when, you know, we said goodbye to each other, Denise was relieved, not only because of what I told her, but because I was still intact. So she said something like, you know, "It's still early, let's go." He said, "You cannot talk to anybody for an hour or so because we have to wait until the press conference." So I said, "How can we possibly go to sleep?" So we talked, and, you know, when the time was up, I called up everybody I could possibly get on the phone. Obviously, I called up my kids. I woke up Minouche in San Francisco. Within a short period of time, a knock on the door, Tom, Jessell, and Jane Dodd and their kids come over with a bottle of wine. The phone is ringing off the hook. A lot of the calls are from Vienna. "Isn't it wonderful, another Austrian Nobel Prize?" And I said, "I think you've got this wrong. This is an American Nobel Prize, an American Jewish Nobel Prize." I thought I would stick it to them. Then I get a call from Columbia. They want to have a press conference. And so I decided, even though it's Yom Kippur, I should obviously want to go to the press conference for me. So I went to the synagogue just to say hello to my friends and tell them this wonderful news, that I would not be there in the afternoon for the, because we went to the press conference. And we went to the press conference. You probably remember that. It was absolutely marvelous. The people in the lab were fantastic. They met me at the door as I came in. It was really a wonderful celebration. And it was clear this was a shared experience. I would never have accomplished this without people at least as good, if not better, than me.